Just earlier today, it was confirmed by the team at Call of Duty, the worldwide reveal is in fact happening on June 8th at 10 p.m. Pacific time, and they also gave us this live-action teaser showing Captain Price, Gaz, Ghost, Soap, and Alejandro. It's really damn cool to see that they're leaning into those live-action shots again, and the fact that we have a team that's comprised of people that can be in live action shots just makes me want an official Call of Duty movie even more. So there's definitely quite a bit going on in this particular teaser. We have the 141 traveling through the desert. Outside the window, you can see that there's trucks with mounted machine guns in the back. And that really does line up with a lot of the leaks that we've been hearing over the past few months in regard to the setting of this particular game. And of course, at the end, we can see them getting into an all-out firefight with helicopters up above in the middle of the desert. You got crazy explosions happening left and right, and that's where it kind of ends, which sucks because it leaves me wanting more, and I think that's what the intention of this particular teaser is supposed to be. Then towards the end of this thing, we can actually see that tagline we just got done talking about a couple of days ago. The ultimate weapon is team. It's such a weird thing to say, but I guess it makes sense in the context of TF-141 coming together to complete the mission. So I'm very excited to see where the campaign takes us. But the information doesn't stop there, because just a couple of days ago, we talked about the rumor of Steam possibly having Call of Duty come back onto the platform. Many of us thought it was a glitch, because if you go down to the bottom of any DLC page from one of the current existing Call of Duty games on Steam, you would actually see Ghost's face, like right there, where you can check out all of the other games of the franchise, but clicking on it didn't take you anywhere. Then later that same day, they removed any trace of that, but now we have Steam given the eyes to Call of Duty, which means, obviously, it's going to be coming back. I mean, I don't see any other reason why Steam would interact with this tweet in any way, shape, or form if it wasn't going to be coming back to their platform. So that means it's most likely going to be available on Battle.net, it's going to be available on Steam, and who knows, maybe in the future it will come to Epic Games Store. But I talked about this entire situation a couple of days ago when this leak happened. So if you want to check out that video, I'll put a link in the description below. One thing that I do want to mention, though, this has a lot of implications for future Call of Duty titles. Like, if we're considering Modern Warfare 2 coming back to Steam, that means that Treyarch's next title will probably come back to Steam, and it's probably going to be bigger than ever with a workshop, mod tools, and stuff like that. So here's to hoping that that comes back in the future, and yes, I hope it comes for Modern Warfare 2 as well, giving us the opportunity to create some amazing things for our community. Beyond the confirmation of the official trailer on June 8th and the live-action trailer we ended up getting today, we also got a little bit of behind-the-scenes information on what's going on with Infinity Ward. They let us know that the team has expanded in Los Angeles in their offices. The studio also expanded down to Mexico. They continue to grow in Poland, and they started up operations recently in Austin, Texas, over just the past 3 years. The teams have been working together with the partner studios and harnessing all of that collective creativity to create Modern Warfare 2. In fact, so much has happened. The studio art director, Joel Emsley, which we've talked about in the past before, he says that this is going to be the most ambitious, beautiful, bombastic, melt-your-face-off game Infinity Ward has ever created. Out of all my years covering Call of Duty, I don't think I've ever heard a developer refer to their game as melt-your-face-off. That is just fantastic to me. I think that's really damn cool. And Joel, of course, has always crushed it on the Infinity Ward side of things. He took a hiatus from social media while developing this game, but now he recently returned with a new account. We also have Candace Harris, the senior producer, saying that the team is thrilled to finally share what they've been working on at Infinity Ward. We cannot wait for people to eventually jump in and play Modern Warfare 2. The quotes continue, though. Stephanie Snowden, the director of communications, says MW2 is an incredibly ambitious title in terms of what we hope to deliver to our fans. The fact that we have been able to develop this game in a hybrid environment throughout the pandemic speaks to the caliber of our talent we have at this studio. And as weird as it is to say this, Infinity Ward just celebrated their 20-year history working on the Call of Duty franchise. 20 years! 20 years, and over those 20 years, they've created some of the most memorable and iconic characters, games, multiplayer. They've really kind of spread their wings and done a lot with this franchise, and I think that they're looking to reinvigorate that and do it again here with Modern Warfare 2. So I'm actually very excited to see what they have in store. So I do want to say, even though I'm excited for the campaign, I am cautiously optimistic about the multiplayer. The multiplayer has me a little bit nervous only because of what we've seen recently this year in Call of Duty Vanguard. See, with Black Ops Cold War, our seasons are structured pretty well in events happening alongside what's going on in Warzone. This year doesn't really seem to be the case with Vanguard, and I've been kind of hearing the same sentiment over and over and over again for the past few years, ever since the integration of Warzone, and that is, multiplayer just kind of seems like an afterthought at this point. And it seems to be like at its head, at its peak right now with Vanguard. Because anytime there's an event going on in Warzone, or there's an update to Warzone, or there's patch notes for Warzone, Vanguard really doesn't seem to get any love in terms of its multiplayer experience. In fact, we can kind of see that now through the seasons with the lack of content that we've been getting, both for the multiplayer side of things and the zombie side of things. I really don't want this to happen again, especially if the rumors are true that Modern Warfare 2 is going to be a two-year game. I just don't think the current seasonal setup that Vanguard has would be sustainable for this game. And I'm talking 1 to 2 maps every 60 to 90 days. Throw some remakes in there, man. Like, give us at least 3 maps, maybe even 4 maps. That would be fantastic. The other thing, too, is how these events have been played out in Vanguard. There's just seemingly nothing happening in the multiplayer. When there's something cool happening, like the Godzilla versus Kong event, there was nothing happening in Vanguard. What was considered an event were 3 bundles. That's it. There was nothing in-game for you to unlock, for you to do. It's just really sad. There wasn't even any unique game modes. That was a really cool opportunity for them to do a unique game mode with Kong or Godzilla. They had the rights to use it. I don't know why they wouldn't have pitched something really cool for Vanguard to do in a set dedicated playlist. And of course, like the rumors were suggesting before, we may only see 5 seasons instead of 6 with Call of Duty Vanguard, especially because now everything is being overshadowed by Modern Warfare 2 and its gigantic over-the-top reveal. I'm here for it, man. I'm ready to move on personally, not because I hate Vanguard, but because it's just so damn boring right now. I want to do something, but at this point, every single time I jump onto Vanguard, it's like, oh, I've completed my battle pass. Oh, I've already done atomic camo. Oh, I don't want to rank up anymore because there's no rewards to earn. There's just nothing keeping me there, unfortunately. So hopefully, turning things around, I'm really hoping that MW2 is just jam-packed full of content, both on the unlocking side by just playing the game, engaging with the game, and not having to worry about whipping out your wallet and, of course, buying bundles all the time. The bundles, I don't mind. I've made bundle videos. I've made tons of different videos about bundles in the past, but Vanguard just feels different. It feels like a cop-out to me. When you look at an event, it shouldn't just be regulated to a $20 bundle. There should also be something happening in-game, allowing everybody to be part of it, giving everybody an opportunity to unlock items in regard to whatever event is currently being held. Good example of this is a St. Patrick's Day event that was allegedly supposed to happen in Vanguard. Unfortunately, just never saw the light of day. We could still see the remnants in the Blueprints Armory. You could see that there's St. Patrick's Day stuff there, but you're never going to be able to unlock it unless they, for some reason, just wait until the next St. Patrick's Day after the fact Modern Warfare 2 has already been out for a few months, and I just can't see them doing anything like that. But anyway, that's my thoughts on it, on multiplayer at least. I'm cautiously optimistic. I'm excited because it's a new game and there's new stuff to do and there's going to be plenty to keep my attention, but at the same time, I don't want it to turn out like Vanguard, where it just seems like it's an afterthought, or it seems like they're not giving it as much attention because maybe there's more people on Warzone, which that's definitely the truth. Warzone has way more community members playing it right now. So I guess I can understand it from that perspective, but there's still a dedicated fan base that's playing standard multiplayer. I just hope that they can keep that in mind. Anyway, that's it for this video today. Thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed, drop a like on it, subscribe for more. In a couple of hours, we have the PlayStation State of Play, and there could be some more stuff announced there, so stay tuned. I might have another video coming out later today. Don't forget to click that subscribe button, and I'll see you all on the next video. Peace.